So my name is Jamie, I'm 25 years old. I'm Australian and I'm a Catholic. And I'd like to share a little bit about my story about how I've come to grow in my faith. And I guess my story is an example of is that there's no situation that you still can't draw hope from. I was raised as a Catholic and never really, I guess, questioned my faith too much. But being Lebanese and coming from that that culture, that religion is almost a part of your identity, and it's so important. And we're constantly praying and we're going to mass. And I would be living with my grandmother at the time was living with us, and it was just ingrained into our being, like praying, church, faith. I was 13 when I really started to question things and just really almost kind of had a very skeptical attitude when it came to religion. And yeah, and I guess a level of rebellion against what people told me that I had to believe in. And I would always think to myself, why are we doing this? And is God real? And then in 2018, everything changed. I just remember coming home one day, and my mom, just I could feel a heaviness in her heart. She said that my father saw a neurologist, and the neurologist said that he has motor neuron disease, and that the outlook is 3 years maximum to live. And I guess it didn't really sink in until in the following days, weeks and months, where we really started to understand that this is going to change our lives forever. And I think that moment is something I can point to as a turning point where I really grew in my faith and where I really almost turned to God in a way and asked him to help us through this, to help navigate us through this crisis and through these challenges. So I started to kind of grow like a desire to know more about Jesus and know more about God. Going to church became something that was important to me. I decided to answer the call and do my first Alpha last year. I also accepted the call to enroll in the Irete Foundations of Missionary Leadership Program, which has been a really amazing experience so far. And I participated in the Camino Walk, and I thought that was just a good way to be in fellowship with other men and to collectively represent our faith. That's something that's really important. And I think, yeah, my involvement in that and the other things that I'm involving myself with in the church, they're really important, and I think that I can really see the way that they've helped me to grow in my faith, finding how it is that I can also contribute uniquely. Like those things have really been something that I've enjoyed, and yeah, I think I've benefited a lot from them.
I think it's a good thing. It's just
yeah, my dad is doing the best he can. He's a strong man. He's got joy in his heart.
He was told that he would only have 2 to 3 years to live. It's been 6 years since that.
We love him and we're all proud of him, and we're going to be by his side every day, and he's never going to walk alone, right? He's always got God, he's got his faith, he's got his family, and we're all there for each other. If I could speak to my younger self, the self that was a bit doubtful and almost pessimistic, I would say to have faith, to just trust in God's plan. Don't be afraid, and everything's going to work out. You still have to have hope.
Proud of my son because he is very blessed. Man, and Jamie and myself very close, and I love Jamie very much.
I love you too, Dad.